Thanks for joining us on a slightly different Slices feature today with a truly weird and wonderful character, Colin de la Plante, aka The Mole. This self-proclaimed Canadian goof has been calling the adventure playground of Berlin his home for quite some time now. With a stellar 10 plus years in the bank, releasing music on a ton of labels, including his own imprint, Maybe Tomorrow. His tunes resemble this kaleidoscopic collage where genres and history meet and engages. And it's this melting pot of ideas and ingredients that's very similar to something else Colin enjoys very much, and that is food. So let's spend some quality time on the table with him now and maybe even play a food game or two. You guys enjoy, and we'll see you next time around. Bon appetit.
Definitely is important for me. My records are important to me. Record shopping, you know, history, getting a sense of history, getting a sense of all kinds of music, seeing all these lost dreams. You know, it's humbling, like you say. You see somebody with, you know, whatever, a hit record, and where are they now? They're driving a, you know, or somebody's driving a truck or whatever. Somebody's made so much talent. Records are essential to me, and in the end, of course, I'm sampling. It's just collage work I'm doing now anyways these days. But I mean, with some synths and some other stuff, of course, whatever. I mean, I don't really understand having files and all that stuff or whatever. Like, I like the objects and all this thing. But yeah, buying records is, it's probably a bad habit. You know, I got a lot in storage right now. It's just a little too much. I got too much stuff. But yeah, huge source of inspiration. Okay.
This is clearly not sushi. This is a good one. I like that one. What was that one?
I have a rule for sampling. I don't take any current electronic music. I'll take some drum machines. But no DJ 12 inches or whatever. Like I won't do it. You know, contemporaries, I'm not gonna sample somebody else's 909, there's one right there, you know, or, you know, it doesn't make sense to me. But everything else, sure, somebody's playing or whatever, yeah. Noise and garbage. There's some stuff I can't touch, some stuff spooks me out. Like Bob Marley or, yeah, some stuff I hold in too high of a, yeah, I don't know. I get the feeling like, okay, it's cannibalism if you eat a person, but like if you're eating their sexual organ, when does it become sex? You know what I mean? Like, it's, yeah, there's a line there somewhere, I don't know where it is, but I feel like I'm dancing around on it, trying to lean to the sex side, I guess, but. So tasty. Having a clue. I don't know. I'm going for it. It's too bad. You guys are gonna hate me. Not a fucking clue. I love eating. Yes, I love it. Yeah, it's great. Yeah, it's a temporary thing. It's a moment thing. It's like music, right? You get it for a moment and you eat it and you experience it and then you make it part of you and then some of it leaves, I guess. Yeah. I am really no good at this game. I suddenly feel like everything tastes like cardboard. I like to think that party, you know, the party in the stomach, was that kids show where there's like a, have you seen it? There's like a dance party and teaching kids how to eat properly. There's like a nightclub and the kid doesn't want to eat his carrots and the party's like, oh, the broccoli is like, oh, we missed the carrot. You know, carrot comes down, the party goes crazy. Kid eats something bad, the party's ruined, stomach's upset. I'm gonna fall asleep here. You're putting something you can't see in your mouth, isn't it? Seems strange. I guess people do it every day. I really don't know. When I'm in there trying to do something good, I'm just trying to like leave my brain behind. You know, if I find myself spacing out, you know, and I feel a cool breeze going through this part of my head, like I know I'm in a good place, that it's working somehow. I don't know, I'm a scientist. I'm a goof, you know, just trying to figure out how my way through, like it's, what, you know, when those guys go off-roading and they see the line and some people are really good and they just, I would probably hack away until you find the way through, you know? That's why I would get a samurai or something small so I can really sidekick. Those are good. Off-roading. Somebody just asked me if I was an idiot or a genius. And I was like, what kind of crazy question is that to ask someone? Like, what are you supposed to say? Like, obviously I'm a genius. You know, it's like, I don't know. Yeah, I'm an idiot. Clearly, I'm an idiot. But yeah, is this the worm? That was good. I don't know what it was. How do I get this in my mouth, you think? Is this good? What is this stuff? What the hell are you feeding me? I try and make stuff for cool DJs to play so that pretty girls can dance and pretty boys too, I guess. I'm aiming for the hips, that's for sure. There's nothing nicer than, you know, dancing from the waist down. that's the stuff. Confusing, so confusing. I can't believe how much I count on my eyes to understand what's going into my face. God. Strange. What a strange... Well, anyway, that was fun. Thanks, guys.
Not a fucking clue.